Hey buddy, welcome back. Today we're doing another coaching session for a Gold 5 Janna game. So I hope you'll enjoy it. So thanks again to Dylan for the wonderful donation to sponsor this. And yeah, let's go ahead and get started here. So if we look at Dylan, who is going by Command Clone in the game, and this is going to be another YouTube version. So we're going to watch it on YouTube. That's just the way that Dylan preferred to do it. And that's an excellent way to do it. We've done it that way in the past. Now that means I'm not going to have as much control over where I click on the map, and I can't always press tab or click on champions to get up-to-date information all the time, but we'll trust that he went through. This is in the replay system, so we can trust that he's going to go through and open up the tab as we go through. I haven't watched it yet, but we'll just do the best that we can to work through it, and I'm sure it'll be great. All right, so looking at the op.gg really quickly. First thing I'll say is, great job in terms of warding for the most part. I see a lot of control wards here. We got 6 in this game, 4 in this one. You have at least a couple in most of them. We got 5 in that one, 6 in that one, 6. So the control ward situation's looking really strong. In the game that he's specifically having me look at here, he has 7 control wards, and, he placed 31 wards, which is, you know, by far more than the Thresh. So that's really good. And it was a 38-minute game. In general, I say aim for at least 5 control wards and one normal, what used to be green wards per minute. So you're coming very, very close to that. If you could place just a couple more green wards, that'd be great. But overall, a wonderful job, and you definitely had more control wards than you needed. So warding looks good. In terms of masteries and runes, you did have a perfect rune set, so that's great. We've got the 9 armor. Marks, seals, flat CDR blues, perfect. And then 1 armor and 2 movement speed quints. This is almost exactly what I recommend. The one thing I would say is there are some matchups where you might want flat HP instead of flat armor, but I also realize that's like 7,000 additional IP for that upgrade, and you know, this is great against most mashups. What you against Thresh, this is actually perfect. You do want more armor instead of HP, but just in general, if you can get your hands on the flat HP, that's a good thing to have around just for those AP matchups, or the flat arm, the flat HP in case you run into the AP matchups like a Zyra bottom lane or, a Sona or a Karma or something that's going to pressure you early, then the flat HP could be better. But armor's fine. It's fine. It's actually better against AD champions like Thresh or like Alistar in lane, and it's going to scale better into the late game. It's just not going to give you as much protection against AP threats early on, but the difference is negligible. So, great job with that. In terms of masteries, the one adjustment I would say is I would go away from Tough Skin and go towards Explorer. This is really, really nice because when you're trying to escape things and you're just moving through brush in your lane, or you're trying to run up river to ward and roam, this is very, very valuable. So I highly recommend running Explorer. This extra 2 damage, something that's important to keep in mind, is it does not apply to lane minions. There used to be a mastery that did apply to lane minions, which are called minions and not monsters. So the fact this says neutral monster is only for jungle camps. So the only real benefit that you're going to get here is 2 less damage from champion auto attacks, which is okay. Very, very early in the game, like levels 1 and 2. But this is just going to be much, much better as the game progresses. Like with that old one, the reason that it was so good, I think it was like 1 or 2 damage reduction from like all sources. And so, you know, if you have, in a team fight, you have 6 or 7 minions beating on you in lane, then it could actually add up and end up preventing a whole lot of damage. But this one, it's not the case with this mastery. They changed it years ago. So you want to move over and start doing Explorer. But other than that, it's just a 1-point difference. But that's one small thing that I would recommend adjusting. Perfect skill order. If we go back over here and we look at builds. Say that you are maxing your E. You can get a second point in Q. You're not going to be able to. We'll see. If Lee's coming and you need a gank, then the W is going to be better. But to stop Thresh from following up on his hook, then Q's better. So it's a minor difference in this lane. It's not a big deal. Like, if you were against a Leona, you would absolutely unequivocally want that Q at level 2. But here, it's fine either way, probably. We'll see how it unfolds. But otherwise, this looks great. Itemization, pretty perfect from what I can see so far. We'll see as the game unfolds. But Rushing Redemption, Ruby Sightstone, selling your coin, and then working your way towards Locket and eventually Ardent Censer. Looks great. That's exactly what I would recommend. I assume you've probably watched my Janna guide. If you haven't, I've got it linked here for you. If you want to watch any Janna videos, I've got a playlist of Janna. Most streams also feature a lot of Janna these days as of patch 7.7. Be sure to check those out if you haven't already. And anyone watching this video that hasn't watched that wants to see some more Janna content, be sure to click on those links. Check that out. Also, I failed to mention that you can get access to this Google Doc in the description to the video. So if you're new to these guides, then you can actually see that. So that's helpful. And I can link some more guides at the end too. I forgot to link that, but I can link all of my coaching sessions for anyone that's watching that wants to find some of those. You can also find that link in the description. Okay, let's go ahead and look at what we're dealing with here. Just in terms of overall composition, and I wrote a few notes down here for you. So we are against, Janna, Ezreal, Victor, Lee, Fiora against Thresh, Twitch, Lux, Nunu, and Malphite. This is going to be really, really hard to win this game, I think. And the reason is Ezreal is... I try to find redeeming factors in this guy, but I really hate Ezreal. He's the most reviled ADC right now, in my opinion, because he doesn't really have an early game. He doesn't have a late game. He has an okay mid game. You know, once he gets his Trinity Force plus Mura Mana, then he does do some pretty good damage. But he's still going to fall behind this Twitch once Twitch gets like 3 items. And he's not going to be able to pressure Twitch in lane at all, so Twitch is probably going to have free farm. It's likely they're going to push into you, but as we'll talk about here in a second, you should try to push into them as much as possible. So yeah, you're going to outscale the Thresh later on, but this Twitch is going to astronomically outscale your Ezreal, most likely. Unless Ezreal gets really, really far ahead early and you guys close out the game by 25 minutes, your team is on the clock. Like, they will beat you late game. There's just no way around that. It's going to be really, really rough to deal with that, because Lee Sin also falls off beyond Nunu. Like, Nunu's kind of a turkey early on. He doesn't do a lot, but later in the game when he puts that attack speed steroid on this Twitch, and when he's like ice blasting and using his ultimate to zone off the Fiora, it's going to be really rough. It's going to be really, really rough. And so we need Fiora to get strong. Like, she's a key to what you're trying to do in this game. But Malphite is a pretty bad matchup for her, because he has the attack speed slow, he's going to build a lot of armor, and he has some really nice engage for them. Now, a lot of your champions can get around his engage. Victor doesn't really have an escape, but like Ezreal can E out of it, and Fiora, I believe, can riposte it. So we'll see how it goes. Lux and Victor is kind of a wash. They both do a lot of damage. Victor has more reliable damage, but Lux has higher burst damage, I believe. So what does that mean? What should you be doing? So as I explained, it's really rough. First of all, I'm not sure the order that you pick these champions, but if you saw that they had a Twitch, you need to pick something other than Janna. As much as I love Janna, you need like a Lulu or a Nautilus, a Fiddlesticks, a Blitzcrank, just something that can get in there and crowd control that Twitch and shut him up. Blitz probably would have been pretty good. Nautilus, as I said, just something. Like, that's one thing that Janna lacks, is she doesn't have a lot of engage. So I don't know if you knew they had a Twitch. It's totally possible they picked Twitch after Janna. But yeah, you want to avoid this in champion select if you can at all help it in the future. If you see Twitch, you can't pick Janna. You have to pick something with more engage. He's a code red. If you see Twitch, he's code red. You have to have engage, and you have to do, like, Twitch and Kog'Maw are code red. You have to have something that can get on those champions and lock them up. You can't let them do their thing as the game unfolds. Okay. So in lane, you want to try to farm and push the waves. It's really hard. Janna doesn't have a lot of lane control. She doesn't have a lot of pushing, but you want to try to put that Twitch under tower if you can. This will make it harder for him to CS, and Ezreal can do something productive while Twitch is under tower, which is spam Qs and maybe hit him with a couple of them. for harassment. If you get pushed under tower, that means that Twitch is basically going to get free farm, and if he's a smart Twitch, he might even be able to roam middle and make plays, or roam in the jungle and make plays, because it's going to be really hard to keep vision up on him if you're constantly pushed under tower, because they can sweep it, and he can just constantly go missing in the lane, and it's going to be really hard to call that, because he just, if he always walks out of vision every time he pushes, it's really hard to keep up with. If Thresh lands a hook on the Ezreal, it shouldn't happen. Ezreal should E away and never get hit, but realistically, he's probably going to get hit, so make sure you use your Tornado to stop the Thresh follow-up. Remember, when he tries to follow in on his chain, you can interrupt him in midair with the hit. That'll at least keep some distance from him, so he can't get a really good ultimate off and other things like that. Then shield the EZ and just try to auto-thresh as much as you can. You can't really trade anything back onto the Rat as Janna. I mean, you can walk up and try to W and auto him a few times if he steps really close, but you don't want to get yourself really close to the point where Thresh can flay you into Twitch and potentially kill you. Because Ezreal should be able to get out after he gets hooked. He's going to take a little bit of punishment from the Twitch, but he should be able to E out of whatever Thresh is going to do. E out of the flay. We'll see. Just make sure you don't get caught up and killed trying to go up and harass the Twitch if they land the hook on your EZ. Okay, so one thing, and it's harder to do this because Janna isn't renowned for her roams, but you've got to try to roam here and make a play, like to close this game out, because you can't just sit down there and farm with Twitch, like just have a farm off with everybody, or you're going to lose the game. So you need to try to coordinate ganks with Lee on Lux. So if you can, try to get mobility boots kind of quickly. I don't think you get... Do you get Moby boots? No, you get Ionians. That's one thing I might change about the build, is go mobility boots, just because you're going to need to roam so much to try to win this game. So it's usually safe to roam with an EZ in your lane, because that's one thing he can do, is farm safely with his Qs typically. So you want to make sure you keep dragon warded and just run up and down that river and try to say, hey Lee, let's go kill the Lux, because Lux is very susceptible to getting ganked. So you want to keep really good vision control, and then try to, like, if you can, run into middle lane and try to gank with the Lee, if at all possible. Watch out for Malphite TP plus ult behind you, so make sure you're keeping your bushes controlled. In the late game, try to protect Fiora if she has any money. I mean, she's one of your only tickets to victory here. It's really tough. I mean, Ezreal, in theory, might be able to do it, but I doubt it. You're going to need that Fiora. It doesn't look like she's going to be that strong, but, you know, just in general, if I don't know all this information, it looks like Twitch does end up going off, which is what I was predicting. But Ezreal looks like he does okay, though. But in general, if Fiora is good, you need to try to shield and protect her and see if you can get her onto the Twitch, because Ezreal's just not going to have the damage to do it. Victor might be okay, but Fiora is someone that you really need to be strong. So you want to protect either Ezreal or Fiora, whoever's doing better. But Fiora, if all else is equal, you want to protect Fiora in teamfights, because she has the money, and if she kills somebody, if you can keep her long enough up to get a kill, then she's going to be able to heal anyone that walks into her ultimate thing. So it's going to be difficult to beat the enemy 5v5, but it's also going to be hard to split push against Twitch, so you don't have a lot of great options here. Try to interrupt the Nunu ultimate also with your Tornado, or your own ultimate if you can. Yeah, and that's about it. So let's go ahead and see what happens. We'll get in here. I'm going to take some notes as usual, and then we'll reconvene at the end and sort of sum up everything that we've tried to learn here. I want to see if I can keep this to about an hour. I know some of these have been going over an hour. I'd like to try to get them to like 45 minutes to an hour total, just to make them a little bit easier to watch in one session. Okay. See, I don't have any kind of speed up option here, which would be nice, but yeah, there shouldn't be a level 1 with these teams. Okay. Level 1 invade. Okay. Try to walk up and help him auto attack the wave. So auto attack these minions. That's what I'm saying. You need to try to push the wave. Like, you cannot let this Twitch push you in. Auto attack these minions. That way you can hit level 2 first and you can push the wave in. Like, in some matchups, it wouldn't matter if you were getting pushed in. Like, if you had a, you know, if you had the Twitch, or if you had some other champion that's going to scale really well, a Vayne or something, sometimes it's not the end of the world if you get pushed in, but especially if they scale harder than you, you can't push in, so it's basically just letting them farm for free. You can't challenge them that much with Ezreal and Janna early on, so you can't actually go up and fight them for the creeps, but you can passively, you can passively push the wave, which will make it harder for them to hit under the tower, so that's kind of what you want to aim for here. You can't fight them for it, but you can make it harder for them to hit. Okay, you need to shield yourself. Or was it down? No, you definitely needed to shield yourself there. Okay, so I'm going to say... auto more to push wave. So yeah, as I described earlier, like, okay, let's see. Yeah, see, as Twitch is up in CS right now. This is not good. Ezreal's already used his biscuit for some reason too. Nice. Okay, well, Fiora starts off really hot. Shield, tornado, there you go. See how he's missing some of the CS because he's under tower? I know it's hard, but, like, just auto-attack these, like, obviously don't make it hard for him to CS, but, like, if they're full health, just throw a couple auto-attacks on him. See, he knows. He's trying to pull himself out. He's auto-attacking the wave to try to get it out. But he is missing CS, and he's going to fall behind over time. Yeah, so it looks like, okay, and then Nunu is taking Dragon right now. This is another reason it's rough. If you get pushed in, it makes it a lot harder for you to keep vision control. So you can't really get wards on that dragon. Now Lee's gonna find him here. Okay, shield him. Now you need to rotate over, help this Lee right now, right now. Like, go up over here and run this way and go help the Lee. You need to ping that Twitch is missing. Yeah, Twitch should not beat you over there. If he gets kills off this, it's gonna be really bad. Yeah, that's real bad. Oh god. So Twitch got a kill, Thresh got a kill, and they got the dragon. That could have probably been prevented if, like, as soon as you see Lee over here on dragon, ping it. You need to ping back immediately in lane and then run up this way through the tri-bush and get over there. Because they're going to come over there and do that. Because they're pushed in like that, then they get to rotate over there and beat you over there if they want to. Like, your only advantage is if you see it first and you ping it and you're the first to react and you're the first one to start running, you might be able to get there around the same time as them or get there later. But if you just sit here and play around with them under tower and they just go invisible like the Twitch did and just run over there, they're going to beat you there by like 5 seconds and the fight's going to be over. And you saw Twitch and Thresh almost instantaneously got 2 kills and a dragon when they showed up. So that's really, really bad. So Twitch is basically even on CS, which is bad. And then they got the dragon, which is really bad, which means they just get to keep spamming their abilities on you without running out of mana, and any harass that you put on them is not going to stick. So Water Dragon is one of the most oppressive dragons in the game. This is also going to give their Lux an advantage over Victor, because now she just gets all that free mana she can use for harassment. And this could potentially help out Malphite against Fiora, help him stabilize a little bit. Now, somehow he got a kill on Fiora up there, too. The jungler wasn't up there. Jungler was down here, so I'm not sure what happened there. But... say... rotate faster to dragon. So that's a really, really big thing that happened here. Like, it's not game over or anything, but it's certainly not great. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward this a little bit, get back in the lane. Okay, so you're still just having a farm off. Yeah. You're still getting pushed in. Wait, did y'all back? Yeah, you backed. Okay. So you backed, Twitch got his back. Farm off. Basically even on CS. You're up marginally, it's not enough. Like, in theory, you need to be up on Twitch. Like, just in general, not in a specific matchup, but in general, you need to be up on Twitch, you know, at least 15 CS in waning phase, because he's going to be so strong later in the game. Like, you have to slow him down. Shield yourself. Tornado. Okay. That's alright. I mean, Ezreal just can't fight him, though. He doesn't have a Sheen yet. You know, I highly advocate... I don't know if this guy was hovering Ezreal or what, but if you had a ban in your ban phase, just ban Ezreal. Like, it's that bad, honestly. I don't typically advocate banning champions so your team won't play him, but it's just catastrophic in, like, these situations if you have an Ezreal and they have a Twitch. Like, this isn't going to become that obvious probably until, like, 25 or 30 minutes into a game, but... okay, you don't have... Did get a Ruby Crystal. As far as your ward goes, I would put that ward in the River Bush here. Because now this Nunu's going to get your buff because you don't have any vision of anything over here. Now your team's starting to think about it, but it's too late. He's already got the buff and he's running out of there. You didn't have enough vision. You should potentially be going up there right now to just see. If they're worried about Nunu there, you could put your red buff up here, or your control ward up here. No, you can't back up now because Nunu could be anywhere in Lee's topside. Fiora is either dead or in base. Though she's top. Okay. Yeah. So Nunu's probably not going to dive you. But, and also you have no mana, or Ezreal has no mana, so. But yeah, you should have had this warded right here. This river bush, or this bush. If you think they're going to check the river bush, then put it in this other bush right here that's on your side of the jungle. Or... you could ward his blue buff itself if you're that worried about Nunu coming in and taking buffs. Which is legit. Like, you should be worried about Nunu taking buffs. Okay, you might need to ult. Yeah, you need to ult. You need to ult. Okay. Okay. That was pretty good defensively. And you need to ping Victor back. Ping him back. Just tell him you don't have mana. Ezreal's had to waste all of his mana last hitting under tower. With his Q. Now he is going up some CS, but... okay, now you don't have... you need to fight him. Like, go fight him right now. If you see that Twitch is top, like, middle, you need to go after him. It's too late. They're probably going to get Victor, too. So this is the problem of not pushing them in, is that they get to do that. They can just roam, and you can't really punish them that hard for it. Because they're going to get to that river first, so they get to roam and you don't, most of the time, if you're pushed in. So you really don't want to be pushed in most of the time. So that's another consequence of being pushed in. Okay, looks like he just backed, so I'm going to fast forward a little bit here. Twitch is backing. Okay, so just push the wave. Yeah, you should have double tapped it faster. I'm not sure if you're using fast cast or not, but if you fast casted that tornado, I think you would have had him to stop his back. Not that it would have mattered that much, because he would have just run. Now Fiora's getting big again. Okay, so she got another kill. She's only even in CS though. Alright, so we'll go ahead and fast forward as you buy. What'd you get? Sightstone. Alright, you need to try to run through here. As Ezreal's going back to lane, you need to run through here and ward this up. Like, try to ward this camp at least, and see if you can also get a ward like in here or something. Just get some deeper wards. Okay, good. There's one ward. Go further. Well, Nunu's cutting you off right now. But try to see if you can get some deeper wards. So that you can keep tabs on Nunu. Okay, so you got the Man Immune. You still don't have Sheen, which in my opinion is bad. I think too many people rush Man Immune. I think you need Sheen a lot faster, because you just don't have any damage. Like, you don't have any spike damage where you can punish this Twitch until he has Sheen. Oh, that was a fail. I mean, you might be able to get him here. Oh, okay, great. Do you have exhaust? Exhaust him. Okay. A little late on the exhaust, but it still worked out. Keep going. Shield, tornado, something. No, everything is on cooldown. If you exhausted a little bit faster there, then Twitch would have had some more mana. Okay, that was good. Alright. Okay, good. Team got turret. You got a couple good plays there. Overall, it's pretty good. Could have exhausted a little bit faster. Certainly, right after your ultimate, you could have exhausted. You probably should have exhausted before your ultimate. I don't know. Sometimes I wait a little bit longer with Janna. Also, because my immediate instinct is to ult and then exhaust after the ult. But you waited, I think, even a couple of seconds after the ult to exhaust. So that could have potentially saved Ezreal, you know, a couple hundred health, and then he could have gone more aggressive and killed that Twitch sooner. Alright, Thresh has Mobis. Okay, now he's got the Sheen. That's good. He didn't go start building Bork or something goofy like that. So you're ahead, but not by much. Twitch is still going to be a lot stronger all in, typically. Now, Janna right now, you know, with your ultimate, you could probably still beat him in 2-on-2 fights. So you should try to get those, especially because you just beat him. And now you have Sheen, which makes Ezreal much, much stronger. Alright, Fiora died. That's not good. I think she died basically solo. I think you can fight him. Maybe you're scared of the Nunu coming down. Yeah, he's on wards. I think he's on wards. Maybe he's not. Yeah, you need to... Okay, you know. Yeah, I would ward... Okay, you do have that warded. Good. I couldn't see it on the minimap. Good. Yeah, just ward over this wall right there. Okay, nice. Okay, great. Now he gets red buff. They got the other dragon though, right? They've got two dragons. I can't see. I'm pretty sure. I can't. Yeah, I think those are two dragons. And that's the tower. Okay, you need to be getting aggressive now, because you have red buff. You still can probably bully up this Twitch once you have that Sheen, because all he has is Blade. If he had gone something like BF plus Zeal, it... You have Exhaust? You don't have Exhaust. Did you... Okay, you just used Exhaust, I think. I'm not really sure why y'all lost that one. I guess maybe the Bork... was too strong now. I thought he had Bork in the last fight. Okay, that was good. Shield. Shield somebody. Okay. Let's see. Twitch is not dead. Nope, not a lot to do here. So overall, pretty good in terms of the fighting. Try to get some better ward cut. Okay, you do have one ward in here. Try to ward those raptor camps, though, and see if you can ward at least down here, if not around his red. Try to get some deeper wards in there. Looking itemization-wise. I would say you definitely want at least tier 1 boots here. I know sometimes, over the past couple weeks, I won't get the boots, but it really is helpful for this kind of game, where you need to be running around a lot. No, leave, leave, leave. You can't fight this. No, y'all should have let that tower go. I'm gonna write that down. Let low towers go. It's one of the toughest things to do sometimes, is just to give them something. But they're gonna take it anyways. There's no way you can stop them. Like, just try to throw your shield on the tower, maybe, and run. Like, do not walk up and try to tornado them or W them or anything. It's just too dangerous. Especially with Twitch and Lux sitting there. If either one of them lands a crowd control, you're dead. And just shield the tower and, like, run. You have no wards right now in the jungle. Which is understandable. I mean, you just died and your wards ran out. So I'm not saying that's, you know, you can't just magically make those wards appear. But I'm just saying you need to be very careful of the Twitch and everyone else. Who all's dead? Okay, two on your side, two on their side, including Twitch. Your jungler's dead, though. You need to go get wards right now on Nunu. On that, on Dragon. Run up around here and go ward that Dragon. Like, now. You need to go do it right now. Their Twitch is dead, so he's not a threat. Like, the only person who's going to stop you from warding that dragon is Nunu, and you can probably get away from Nunu. It's so scary. Yeah, you waited a bit too long. You're letting everyone get in position to threaten you. It's extremely dangerous for him to do that. Okay, it worked out, though. Sort of, kind of. You do have redemption, right? Yeah, you need to be throwing redemption in here. Throw redemption. Did you already use it? I did not see you use it. Like, in here where everyone's trying to contest this dragon and you had, like, two or three people that are, like, 50% or less, just go ahead and throw your redemption on top of them. Just top them off. Just make sure. Because if they get low, don't forget, if that Twitch comes in and pops off and just starts killing two or three people and gets resets on his invisibility, it's going to be very, very difficult to deal with. So I'll just say, use redemption faster. Now, I can't tell if it was on cooldown or not. So, you know, obviously, if it was on cooldown, you can't use it, but just in general, that would have been a good place to use it. I don't remember seeing you use it in any of the over the last 2 minutes. Need to ping her back. Need to get out of there. Twitch is missing. He's invisible. Yeah, double kill for... Yeah, you needed to ping her back. There's nothing that y'all are going to accomplish down here, right? Under that tower. Once they get to that tower and she doesn't get the kill, when her ultimate goes off, that's it. It's done. Play's dead. Get out of there. It's already dicey to go into a 2-on-3 situation. But definitely once you don't secure that kill and Twitch is, like, missing and he, you know, can go invisible, you need to get out of there. So, Ping allies back more. I'm going to say ward deeper. Shot call. Shot call decisively about things. Alright. Let's see here. It's a dangerous pink, but I suppose you can get it. Like, if Twitch shows up there. Ult probably wasn't entirely necessary, but I understand the sentiment. They need to notice that Thresh did rush Talisman also, so that's really scary. Like, I don't think that's as powerful as Redemption, but it's a scary item if they're ahead, which they are. Like, technically, it doesn't look like they are with Twitch. Oh, God. See, he finished Blade of the Ruined King before his Trinity Force. That's really, really bad. So, I was applauding this Ezreal for going Sheen before Blade, but he really, really wants to go. He should be going Trinity before Blade. Oh, God. Did you use Redemption in here somewhere? You're not gonna... I don't think you're gonna kill him. No. You don't do any damage, man. You're Janna. You gotta run. Like, Nunu's gonna have a lot of armor and just health, and he can heal himself off of his Q. Yeah, you don't really want to do that in there. No, I didn't see a redemption. Let me go back and see. Okay, there it was. Okay, so you did use it. So that was alright. It was a good instinct. Okay, let's go ahead and move the next thing. You maybe could have placed that a little bit better. I couldn't see what was going on down there from this point of view, but... overall, I do think that, you know, it's fine. You tried to use it somewhere. Redemption's a really hard item to use correctly. I would say definitely ping, though. When you cast your redemption, ping on top of it so that people can see it. So they'll look at the area and they'll be like, oh, it's a redemption. That's something that I've found helps a lot. Now, I don't know if your redemption's up. There you go. Nunu got it. Run, yeah. Try to redemption and... okay, great. That was a good one. Yeah, you don't have your ult. No, that's... That's probably game right there. How much longer? Yeah. So what happened there? I'd say. Yeah, you need to get down there with them. Yeah, I know you're trying to clear that wave or something, but Janna just has no wave clear. Just ping them back right now. Ping them back. You need to be pinging back like 3 times. Faster than that. Like, you did ping once, but ping a lot more once you see them down there doing that, and just ping yourself that you're missing. And just tell them to get out of there. Like, ping back. You need to keep pinging and ping your cooldowns. Let them know you don't have ult. You don't have... You need to exhaust somebody in here. Even if it's just Malphite, just use it. Yeah, it was catastrophic. I assume you probably don't have redemption either. Unless you just use it and I didn't see it. Like, right there would have been a good spot to redemption. I know you don't have ult. Yeah, so I'm gonna say ping. Do I say ping allies back more? Yeah, I've got that on there. So ping your cooldowns. I don't know if I can tell if you're pinging stuff on here. I can see that you pinged back once, which is good. But you need to be pinging back a lot, and then ping yourself. First of all, don't be up here. You know, it's just luck split pushing. She's not going to do a lot, and you're not going to do a lot. So you need to be down there faster. But you also need to ping and let them know that your ultimate is... your ultimate's on cooldown, and ping them and let them know if your redemption's on cooldown. So yeah, don't try to go wave clear with Janna if the rest of your team is doing something else on the map, because you just don't. Okay, so let's say that. Stay with team. No wave clear. Now with most champions, you should, you know, try to stay with your team, but... Yeah, don't flank, don't flank. Janna's not really a flanker. But doubly so with Janna, you need to stay with your team, because you just don't have any wave clear. Like, you're just not going to kill minions that quickly. Okay, you got a couple of kills. Why are you running back? Yeah, stick with Ezreal. Okay, that's an ace. Yeah, get Baron. I thought they were going to get Baron. I guess they stopped it, and... I don't know what they're doing. Okay, so you do have a chance. Well, I thought the game was going to be over after they aced you. I thought for sure they're going to ace you middle and just run straight at Baron and get it, but I guess they goofed something up. Okay. This should give you lock it, right? Yeah, okay, good. Now you're pretty strong. You still have the problem of getting to Twitch. You need to tell people they need to kill Twitch right now. He's really the only thing that matters. That Lux doesn't matter. Malphite doesn't matter. Now, Malphite is building some AP. Victor got caught and killed. Fiora does have her TP, so it's okay if she's bottom. You need to ping people back. It's a 4v5. Ping him back. No. You could be getting... Like, you need to ward this right here. Because they just killed Victor top lane, so you know they're top. Yeah, they're going to kill you both. Or at least him. You need to run. It's too late on the... Just don't even use your redemption right there. Yeah. Oh, you did have this warded. Maybe they ran around this way. I'm not really sure, but you need to ping him back out of there. And if for some reason he doesn't go back, you need to... Oh, you need to ward this stuff. No, you didn't have it warded. I think. It was just... Let me see. You have a very small ward here, but it's going to be too late. Okay. Go forward a little bit while you're dead. Yeah, you need to ping her back. You need to just let these people know they shouldn't be... Okay, maybe you did. It says you signaled careful there, so that's good. No, 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 no. Don't do that. Don't do that. You don't want to flank as Janna. It's a bit late on the redemptions. You need these redemptions to be a bit faster and more crisp. I know that Twitch is just blowing people up. Now, I'm going to assume you didn't have any wards for him. If you don't see Twitch, assume he's just about to murder your whole team. So you need to, like, ward over this wall for him. You need to ward behind you for him. You may have seen him right there, maybe. Like, you need to constantly ping and tell your team, like, that Twitch is missing so they don't run out like that. Like, don't just ping back. Like, ping, you can ping the portrait of Twitch on the tab screen. Just ping him, like, 3 or 4 times. Anytime your team is overextending and you don't see Twitch on the map, you need to ping him 3 or 4 times. And then people will understand, oh, yeah, Twitch. Because people just forget, like, that he could be anywhere, anytime, and completely murder you. This is why he's the number one ADC right now, I think. For solo queue, especially. Either Twitch or Draven. I mean, it's one of those two. But that's part of what makes Twitch so scary if he gets ahead. He's not even really that far ahead, right? Like, ahead. You know, he's 10 and 7, and your Ezreal's 10 and 6, but the problem is he's Twitch, so he actually does something. That stealth just makes it very difficult to play around it in solo queue, because people never respect his invisibility. Because it's no fun to respect it. That means you can't do anything, hardly. He exerts so much map pressure because he could be anywhere. So you need more wards in your red side jungle for him. You had one that potentially could have spotted him, but I think he was invisible and ran past it while he was invisible. Right, it should be the game-ending fight here in a second. It's difficult to say what you can do at this point. They have that that top inhibitor down. You're in a really tough spot. Just try to protect Fiora if you can. Fiora has to be the one to get on him, or Lee, to get to that back line. Alright, Protector, use your Locket and Redemption. Yeah, don't run that close to ult. Okay. Oh no, Twitch got her. Okay. I thought she got him for a second. Yeah, don't run that close. I'll say stay back. Like, don't try to run so close that you're blowing people back with your ultimate. Sometimes you just have to stay on the very back line and just use it to heal. Because they're just going to blow you up if you do that. Just drop your redemption when the fight starts. Lock it to shield as many people as you can. And then if you have to, just hang out in the back, use your ultimate, use your shields. Their team's pretty good against Janna, like I said, you know, because you can't do anything to threaten Twitch, really. And your shields and your heals are not going to do a lot if someone gets hit with a Lux Bind or a Thresh Hook. And Malphite can't be stopped by your Tornado, so it's a really rough composition for Janna, but you did have chances to win in there, potentially. Okay. So here's what I have collated to bring it together for some final notes here. Auto more and push wave early. This will give you faster rotations and more vision. So that was a huge thing early on, is they got the dragon specifically because you weren't pushed up. So you weren't able to keep wards out there and you weren't able to rotate fast enough. They were able to get there faster because they had you pushed into your tower. Rotate faster, particularly to the early dragon. So in this game, rotate into the dragon, but just in general, just be ready to run. If you see a fight breaking out, be ready to get there. If someone pings that dragon, you need to hook around and get there as fast as you can. Like I said, the best route, because you were pushing a tower right here, is to go up through here and run around. Now, that's going to be a bit slower than them just running right here, but if you leave fast enough, then you can get over there about the same time they get there. So if there's a fight breaking out there, or if someone's like, hey, there's someone invading my jungle right here, or whatever, you need to just leave immediately and go do it. You're going to lose a bit of experience in the lane, but it's worth it to protect your jungle and protect dragon. Let low towers fall. So that was a pretty big play bottom lane. They got a double kill, and I think they killed you, and then maybe got a dragon off of it and a tower. I know they at least got the tower itself and a couple of kills. So if towers are low and there's just nothing you can do to fight three people, like you're not going to fight them with Janna Ezreal, then just let it go. Use redemption faster. So there were several times where the redemption would go off after people were already dead. So just err on the side of just using it quickly. And you did that in a couple of fights. But try to do that more. Just use it quickly. Just throw it right into the cluster of people, whoever's starting to fight. And just make sure that it's on cooldown and that it's actually going to affect people before they die. If you overheal them a little bit, that's fine early on. Obviously, don't just drop it on a full health person who's not being injured. But anyone that, like, you know they're going to be taking damage over the next 2.5 seconds, especially if it's multiple people, just go ahead and throw it on them. Don't wait until they're almost dead. So it's better to get some healing off and have a little bit of overhealing rather than get no healing after the person's dead. Just make sure you're using redemption faster. Ping allies back more. Ping your CDs. Shot call. So you need to direct them to do stuff or they're just not going to do it. So tell them, hey, let's go do this. Hey, let's back up. Hey, let's group up and go do this over here. So just let them know where they need to be and use your pings a lot more, especially on other stuff. So back pings are good, but pinging why you're back pinging is good too. So don't only just ping back ping, but ping back ping and then like ping Twitch's portrait like 3 or 4 times so that people get the picture. Oh, Twitch is there. Or back ping a lot and then ping your own portrait and just say, oh, Janna's not there. Or ping your cooldown and say, okay, we shouldn't fight this because Janna doesn't have her ultimate, she doesn't have exhaust, and she doesn't have redemption. Now, people in Gold 5 may not necessarily like respect that. They may not know, oh, we shouldn't fight because Janna doesn't have her ultimate. But that way, at least you're giving them, you know, really good information. So if you ping back, they know why you're pinging back because you don't have your ultimate. So they might still do ridiculous stuff, but there is a certain percentage of players that will respect that and try to play a little bit safer. Ward deeper. So especially in the early game, you were just getting like some very shallow wards, but you need to try to ward deeper to keep an eye on where that Nunu is. And you should have opportunities to do that because Nunu's not that threatening. You could probably get away from him if you run into him in the river. And Ezreal should be safe farming bottom, so you should try to get some wards. I talk about this in my warding video, but if you don't feel safe running all the way into the jungle there, you can at least run up here and just ward over this dragon pit, like right here. And then that way it'll see if he's running through this alleyway anywhere. So you can't really defend this tri-bush, like you can't ward this because they're going to have it pinked and you're just pushed in all game. But you can ward dragon, like ward here, and then just run up and at least like ward this ramp. If you don't think you can get to ward here. Like, warding here is great, because that spots the raptors, and that keeps track of this ramp area. But if you can't do that, at least try to run up and ward, like, here, so that you can see the river, and you can see all of this. Don't ward here, if you can, because this doesn't give you a lot of vision. It doesn't give you vision of the river, and it doesn't give you vision of the raptors. This is, like, one of the worst places you can ward. Unless you're about to do a dragon, and you need, like, vision of that bush. Like, ward here, or ward here. But you could have easily warded here over the dragon pit just to get better vision. Because I think all you were doing is you're like warding this, you're warding like dragon some, which is okay. But try to go deeper to see if you can spot him in transit. Stay with team more. Don't flank. Don't wave clear. So that this is one major thing, is there were a couple of fights in there where you were like flanking. You're trying to come up from behind them to do some stuff, or you're trying to get vision in a bush. Like near the end of the game, like all of your people were fighting here, and I think you came in and tried to flank around here to do something. Don't do that. They're going to catch you out of position and kill you, which I think is what happened. Like right here, you were like sitting in this bush watching them, and you saw a Malphite like right here, and like people were here and here. Don't do that because if they ever spot you in here, you're trapped and you run out. Just hang out on the back line as much as possible and just try to shield and peel and protect. Like your team doesn't have very good engage, so that's a problem. But it's not a problem you can fix with Janna. You're just gonna have to play Janna as well as you can, and don't try to hit them with W's. Don't try to flash ult them. I didn't see you doing that much, but just do your role, play it on the back line, and be careful. Because remember, if you're behind your allies, that actually lets them retreat and run back faster, which could be relevant. Okay, that's what I have also. Oops. Stay back. Don't flank. Don't wave clear. Okay. So don't try to run up on the front line and blow people back with your ultimate if you're going to take a lot of heat for that. Just hang out on the back line and use your ultimate just for the healing. Because you can't really push most of them off, as I described. Like, you're not going to push Twitch away. Like, Lux, these are both very long range champions. It's not going to matter if you push Thresh back. Malphite's just going to ult right through you if you push him back. Nunu's not going to care if you push him back. He's just going to run back in. There's really nobody that you could push back that's going to matter. It's not like they have like a Talon or a Kha'Zix or a Rengar or something like that. It's just your ultimate is not going to matter for its knockback most of the time. You just primarily want to use it for the heal. So it's okay if you're not knocking people back if you're just healing with it on the back line. Okay, well, that's gonna be it. Overall, pretty good. I think that your fighting, for the most part, was good. There's a couple of, like I said, flanking things and stuff where you're running to the front line too much, but overall, it was pretty solid. I thought that your ults were on point. Use exhaust a little bit more. I wonder if I had that in there or not in terms of the. And use exhaust more and faster. Okay. But overall, yeah, pretty good fighting, pretty good instincts in lane. Just work a little bit on the macro stuff in terms of rotating, shot calling, pinging stuff, communicating information to your team. Just use that redemption exhaust a little bit faster. You were using them in most fights, and you had some really good redemptions in there and some really good exhaust. Just try to do it a bit faster. Ward a little bit deeper when you can. Stay with the team. Don't flank or wave clear. But overall, pretty solid game. Like I said, it was going to be rough because of the matchups. But you did have some chances where you were like, you could come back into the game. And just one thing that's not in the game, as I said before, is I would not pick Janna. If you were like fifth pick or something and you knew they had Twitch and you had Ezreal, definitely do not pick Janna. You want to go for, like I said, the Lulu, the Nautilus. What's in your repertoire here? What do you play? Let me see. Yeah, Nautilus. That's a lot of CS with Nautilus. It looks like you probably play him top primarily. But you could consider him playing as support also. Now, it looks like you've switched to a lot of Janna. But you could definitely play Nautilus as support potentially against something like a Twitch. Because then that way you have some engage to try to fight him. Or you can always dodge. I mean, if you have Ezreal versus Twitch, I know, it's kind of tongue in cheek, but it's kind of serious. Like, it's going to be really hard for you to win that game. Like, you did have chances, but that is one if you haven't used your dodge for the day where you might just want to use a 3-point dodge on it because it's a pretty dire circumstance, the team comps. But anyways, that's going to be it. Thank you very much. Hopefully this helps you out a little bit. Let me know if you have any questions. Just shoot me an email. For anyone else that's new to the channel, as I said before, if you want to watch this coaching video and you want to watch more coaching, or I guess you watch this one obviously, but if you want to watch more coaching on the channel, I've got an entire playlist of coaching videos here. Yeah, so you can just go through, watch all the coaching that you want. Also have other guides, like very specific champion guides, topical guides, such as how to do vision better, how to itemize better, past streams, different playlists for champions. So if you want to play, or if you just want to watch a lot of Janna, Nautilus, Tahm Kench, Syrah, got all kinds of VODs about that. And yeah, that's going to be it. So have a wonderful day, and I'll see you next time.